क्लास 5 कंप्यूटर चैप्टर 2 टाइप्स ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर पार्ट 2 टॉपिक्स फॉर टुडे आर व्हाट इज ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम फंक्शंस ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड टाइप्स ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। चिल्ड्रन वी ऑल लर्नड दैट सॉफ्टवेयर is something which is run on the computer hardware. They work together to make the computer complete or the system complete. Then only we can work on the computer. So what is software? Software is a collection of programs that are stored and run on the computer hardware. And this helps the user or us to work on the computer. Hardware are those part of the computer which we can see and touch, and software is that part of a computer which we cannot see or touch. And we also learned that software is of two types. One is the system software and the other is the application software. We are learning about the system software in these classes. In my previous class I told you that system software is further divided into three main types, and they are operating system, utility software and language processor. So in this class we are going to cover one of that type of the system software, that is operating system. So now let's know what is an operating system. An operating system is needed to operate a computer. It controls the overall activities of a computer. It's a link between the user and the hardware. When you go to a computer lab and when you switch on, some time is used to boot the computer, and the first program that gets loaded in its memory is the operating system. An operating system, to give an example, an operating system works like the principal of your school. As a principal has various responsibility to manage the school, this operating system also does various tasks. So let me give you some example by the name of these. You would come to know that these are the operating systems. You might have heard these names in your daily life. MS-DOS or Microsoft Disk Operating System. This is one of the oldest Microsoft operating system. Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 8, Unix, Linux, Mac OS, or some recently, or the not very old, but the latest ones, the different versions of the currently used operating systems. So now, as we know what is an operating system, we have understood it controls the overall activity of a computer. It's a link between us and the hardware. Now, what are the main functions of an operating system? How does it work for us? Let's understand that. The main functions of an operating system are device management, memory management, runs software for us, processor management, file management, and security. Let's cover them one by one. Device management means the devices or the parts of the computer. It manages these parts like input devices like mouse, keyboard, output devices like monitor, printer. All these are controlled by the operating system. Its working is all controlled by the operating system. Then comes memory management. This is very important because it assigns memory to various programs. Whenever there is program is run, this helps in the assigning or allotting memory to various programs, and it also frees the memory when it is not in use. Then comes software running the software on it means different softwares like application softwares like Paint. These are applications of, they are called application because they are used for some particular task. Like Paint software is used for painting, coloring. Microsoft Word is used for typing letters, words and sentences. Microsoft PowerPoint is used for making presentations. So these application softwares are run with the help of the operating system. Then comes processor management. An operating system manages the working of the processor by allocating various jobs to it. Various tasks is allocated to it. Then comes the file management. Means file management, we all know we create file, we delete file, we copy file, we store file on the computer, we move from one place to one folder to another, and we store it in a folder in an alphabetical order or date wise. All these are done in a very organized way. This what helps in doing all these things? The operating system. It keeps track of all these information. The next function of the operating system is security. It provides security by means of password. Means how can we protect the computer from being misused? Means if our computer, we don't want anyone to look into our data, whatever we have stored in our computer. How can we do that? By giving password to it. Like we can protect the mobile also with password, the same way this computer can also be protected by a password, and this operating system helps in through operating system. The next topic that we are going to cover is the types of operating system. There are many operating systems that are available in the market, and I just now took some names of some popular operating system. Based on the features of these operating systems, they have been classified into three operating systems here. One is single user operating system, multi-user operating system, and multitasking operating system. What is single user operating system? Single user operating system allows only one user to use computer system at a given time. This is the most common type of operating system that is used in homes and offices. We use in our whatever we have loaded in our computer at home, the home computers and the home office computers that are not connected to the LAN or something. These computers are called the single user operating system. Then multi-user operating system allows multiple users, many, like the word says multi means many, many users on different computers to access a system. One system can be accessed at the same time through a network. Main computer is connected to all other computers. Like we have this kind of setup in our computer lab also. The multi-user operating system can handle the various needs and requests of all the users simultaneously at the same time. Linux and Unix are the examples of multi-user operating system. This Linux and Unix are called the multi-user operating system. In this type of system, resources of the main computer are shared among the user, can be accessed by other users. For example, in a computer lab, a single printer is attached with all the computer devices. You all know that how we use a printer. One printer is attached through the network, and from any computer we can give print command. Multitasking operating system allows a user to run more than one application program. Like we can, application program I told you, I took some name like Paint, Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, all these are application programs. And when we are using multitasking operating system, it allows us to work on many application program at the same time. In multitasking, the operating system keep tracks of the program you are in and allows you to switch from change from one program to another without losing information. If you stop working on Excel and go to Paint, it will not lose the data. It will not close the document. It will be there for you. And then once you have done your drawing, without closing, you can come to the other program. So this is called the multitasking facility. So you can enjoy music also at the same time. So there you can do many tasks at the same time. So Windows operating system is a multitasking operating system. So children, in this session we will cover only this much. I will be covering the next type of system software, that is utility software, in my next class. I will be sending a PDF file for you to do some homework in your copy. You will revise the note and do the homework well. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.